Good morning, everybody. Now I have the pleasure to present you a bit this topic out of the viewpoint of operators, because we have heard now a lot of administrative topics and regulatory tasks, but there are around some operators which are doing the organic job and doing the product on primary production, on processing, and even on trade. And I think I would like to draw your attention a bit on this side. First of all, let's have a look. Okay, let's have a look on the current situation as we see it. We have a control system in place. It is, I think, the most developed chain integrated control system in the whole food market. We have now experienced it over 20 years as a state control system and before as a private control system. We have today in place a system process oriented quality concept, which safeguarded by a control concept which we had heard about in the previous speeches. And we have a situation now, a fast-growing market is challenging this control system, for example, by fraud cases, which has come up over the last years, which needs maybe to which ask for adaption of the control system as such. But I will not keep you in the dark about the other situation. As operators, we are trained even with other control systems. There are not only the organic control system around which is infecting the operators, there are even other control systems which are in place in the operations on different levels in the food chain. So first of all, what is today the problem for organic integrity? Because I called my presentation organic integrity. And for those operators which have really invested in this market, the question of integrity is an extremely important one. And we are not only the bad guys, we always try to overcome the regulations or things like that, which is sometimes around in if I'm looking for authorities or state sites. So I think there are two areas of problems which we are facing. The first area is the area of, yes, of mistakes and negligence, where things was not fully understood, where mistakes occurred in the process and things like that. And the second level is a question of fraud. Intentional break of the rules, try to take money out of doing things which are completely against the rec and completely mostly against the interests of the other people and other operators in the food chain. Looking at the report, which was carried out by FVO and which was mentioned by you some minutes ago, I think I like to highlight simply that for the German situation, it's quite clear the control system as it is established via 834 now is working. So there are some problems, there are some space for improvement, but generally overall, a good system for control of organic production and labeling of organic products is implemented. That is one of the sentences of your conclusions and some more. You give these informations before. How to overcome mistakes? That is, in a way, the first bullet of what I have presented before. And I think with the current audit system which we have in place, the annual visits, coming to the operators, announced, not unannounced, meeting the responsibles of the operation, having checked their quality assurance systems, having checked what they are doing in daily practice, how they have organized their operations, that is a perfect tool for checking and improving the performance of the operators. It's a perfect tool for a continuous improvement of the performance, of the abilities of the operators to fulfill the regulation. It provides guidance and for improving the management, and at least it gives some space. And it's, for example, I gave one example. We now launched here during Biofach tomorrow a risk model for sourcing activities for operators. It gives space for having improved systems, quality assurance systems in place in order to overcome risks in the market, which is one of the main targets of these operators, which really are active in this market. I think the organic control system is here really best practice from my point of view, even compared to other control systems which we are know from the food sector at all. The next topic is a bit about fraud. I think fraud prevention is in the current control system, but we as operators see it a bit in the direction that a certain, I would say, a certain, how to say, a need is to distinguish a bit on the activities carried out. We see it a bit critical to mix the audit system with the investigative control system in a too intensive way, because in a worst consequence, we get rid of the audit system, and that is absolutely what we not want to see. Therefore, and we think there are four points for our point of view which are really important to mention. First of all, we need a control system and we need a regulation which is enforcing the operators to take full responsibility. If the control systems are working against the responsibility of the operators, then we could not use their intelligence, their knowledge for safeguarding the system. And that is extremely dangerous. And we have in the current regulation some elements which are tend to be like this, and that have to be rethinked. Secondly, we think we have a bit to distinguish from the audit control system this investigative control element. I would call it like this, with flexible legal and technical instruments. And that not only means analyzing, it means, and it was presented by colleagues here, cross checks, traceability checks, unannounced visits. But I like to remind you, it even means maybe other legal instruments as the control bodies have it today, in order to do an efficient fraud prevention. At least it's about punishment and sanctions for some operators, and we have seen this traders doing international trade, having no brand in a market, having established their operation in one day, in fact, hiring some people which knowing the process, having some connections, can do very easily fraud. They have nothing to invest. It means they have nothing to lose. And if they search for the right place, they have no fear for punishment. It means state punishment, in fact, because no measures are in place. Yeah, and the last point I mentioned, it's about a control system and a regulatory framework which is make use out of the operator's competence and not destroying this competence or how to say, putting it in the dark. So wait a minute. So we have some legislative project in front of us. It was mentioned before, looking at the topic of 882 and 834. I give simple the information for us. It's in the moment a bit confusing to understand what's going on. In fact, of these overlapping processes which we have in front of us, two topics which seems for us very important here is one thing which even was mentioned. It is a topic that the process orientations as a core quality element of organic production have to be kept in future. That is for us extremely important and not replaced by a product approach, because we think that is giving a total wrong direction even in terms of the expectations and perceptions of our consumers. They expect that we have a process organized and not a single constituent in an end product. And the second topic is about a competence, how to keep this agriculture and even processing competence, process competence into the system. That is the next question, which is challenging for our point of view, and hope we will find solutions. Now coming to another task, which I like to highlight a bit, because I find actual data on official control, and that was for me quite interesting, because we here in Germany, and I'm speaking even for the German umbrella, we have a certain discussion on maybe we should have a public control system and not anymore this control system based on private control bodies in place. And I find some nice figures. We have in Germany food companies, it's official figures from our agriculture ministry, 1.2 million of food companies working. Last year, by the official control, oh no, it's 2012, these figures refer to. Of these companies, 500,000 was visit. It means 43%, in fact. Control visits at all, it was 800,000 and a bit more than 800,000, because some of them was visit doubled. And irregularities was detected from this company's visit. It means only not at all the half, in fact. It was 383,000. So it means 61%. Looking for the organic control system, we have in Germany 93,000 operators working. 39,000, sorry. All of them was visited in 2012. We have control visited all 49,000 control visited. It means 120% in fact. So the control density, the control intensity is much higher than in official control. And then I have some nice figures on irregularities. So official report from our ministry is saying 0.25% of irregularities was found. These figures cannot really compare because it's irregularities in accordance to Article 30 of 834. So be a bit careful. I offered you another figure from Alexander Zorni, who has done a PhD thesis and have worked on the CERT cost project. Maybe some of you have heard from it. He find out that 24% of the operators had slight problems, which was stated and needs a certain adaptation in the process. 2.9% has middle scored problems which caused a certain stronger sanctions to the operator. And SURF sanctions, and that is comparing to the data which we see from the official report, 1.5% was SURF sanctions in accordance to Article 30. Only to give you an overview. So I would like to say, looking at these figures, we have a very efficient control system compared to the official control system by food. I know I'm a bit unfair because the target of the official system is a bit different. Forgive me for that, but I think the figures are quite interesting from my point of view. Let's go for the next. I find an article from Europol last year. It's from December 2012, which is simply saying there is a lot of fraud going on in a conventional food market, a lot of fraud. I will summarize it like that. Everybody can read it. You can give this Interpol information. You can find this Interpol information on the web. Third, I will come to a topic which is quite nervous around in a moment. It's about irregularities and fraud. And the question of residues. So Emmanuel is putting pressure on me. Because this residue topic is very important, so I find a slide from a German authority which is doing regularly residue testing. And for me, I will not bother you with these figures. So you see there are quite differences. For example, Israel has 2.3% of the samples find some residue problems. And for example, Greece 8.9%, and for example, Italy 9.2%. I only want to highlight one topic. Italy is here on this table, the only country with a fixed threshold. My message is to set a threshold has nothing to do with avoiding, or has nothing to do with having more or less contaminations. Be careful. I have another figure before I think I have to stop. I think because it will present this figure, I have it not written on the slide, because I think it is very important for the current discussion. If you take these figures from Baden-Württemberg, also from the official eco-control, residue control system, then you find out that in more than 20% of the samples taken, there are residues, there are a presence of residues. If the presence of residues will be the incentive to open up a notification procedure over control bodies and our authorities, that will mean we block the system. So I think it is quite clear that a certain system is needed in order to handle in an appropriate way and to find out what types of residue findings are relevant and what types of residue findings are not relevant. And that is, I think, the most tricky topic here in this framework. You allow me a last minute. He allows me 5 minutes ago. So, first of all, Emmanuel, I would like to summarize. Operators have the key influence on the products. That is quite clear, and not control systems. So, a control system need to establish responsibility within the operator, and you have to enforce them to take the full responsibility. If it's not doing like this, then it will fail. And that means the staff needs information and operators have to introduce For example, quality assurance systems on different levels, depending on the size of the operators. And I'm starting to be a bit angry because as a former revision, it was the revision of 834. It means it's now 7-8 years ago. The regulation established with Article 26 a system saying each operator should have a quality assurance, it means organic control, critical control point system in place. In fact, it was never really systematically introduced in practice. I think that is extreme weakness of the system. And this should is a question not of regulatory background, it's a question of implementation. And I really ask why this was not implemented. Because in fact, from my point of view, this system works together with the current Article 91, which we have even in a current 889 in place. It works perfectly together. But it must be clear that the interface in between control and operators' responsibility is in fact the operators' quality assurance systems, developed on different levels for sure. It depends on the size of the operation, but this should be, and this will give an efficient interface. And that is what we are needing. And I really inspire even the COM to think in this direction and not to think in sampling and in a way which is excluding or maybe is in the worst case bothering these operators with take full responsibility, look for good labs, look for good results, and work together with maybe in collective quality assurance systems. And this operator should be inspired to take this full responsibility and not, in a way, bothered by a regulatory system which makes their living much more complicated. And at least we think it is absolutely needed to stay in a concept where the control system is certifying the competence of the operator, not the product. We think it is extremely mistake and misunderstanding of the functionality of markets and of the functionality of efficient control systems to think that state can really take over responsibilities for the final product. That has to be stay with the operators and state, as we have it in organic regulation in place or elaborated as many years, it is about the competence of the operator side of certified. Thank you very much.